it's been very well received in the fashion world. I mean, I think that there is a bit of novelty because of what it's made from. But there's a lot of people that do bone jewelry, really. There's just not anything quite so elaborate.
As much as the tattooing shows drove a lot of the industry crazy, I have to admit, as a woman, they made it infinitely easier for me. And I owe it to people like Kat Von D and Kim Say and Hannah Atchison, who, you know, were brave enough to go on TV and stick their necks out and, you know, risk the Hollywood industry to, you know, make tattooing more popular. And they changed the career for all tattooers, and especially young female tattooers.
I got into music because when I was 8 years old, I was watching TV and I was a visual artist already. I've drawn since I was a little boy, and an ad for a record store came on TV and these album covers would spin and hit the, you know, like trying to hype up the new release, you know, bam, this record's available, this record. And this album, Rock and Roll Over by Kiss, hit the screen. And it was the coolest looking thing I'd ever seen in my life. So I made my dad take me to the record store, and I got my lawn mowing money or whatever chore money it was that I had, and I bought that record, and that was it. That moment that I dropped that needle, I knew I was going to be involved in music.
The punk scene in Lubbock never should have happened. You had people coming from all over America, all different backgrounds, that all were trying to escape something to get here. And they were all people with pain, and they were all kind of damaged by something. And they all wound up in Lubbock at the same time. And they all liked the same kind of music. And they all like kind of had this same mindset. I was so shocked when I ran into that, because it was like my people, I finally found them, you know. In Lubbock, Texas in 1985, punk rockers.